Hi everybody, my name is Shane.
And I'm Guy.
Today we're going to put a little video together to talk to you about Magna Cut and why we made the changes to go that direction. So we made a little list here of some of the most asked questions regarding Magna Cut. And we're just going to kind of go through it. And these are questions directed from you guys. We'll hit the hit list and then we'll go through it and get you guys some information. So Guy, one of the number one questions we have been getting is why? Why did my order change? Why did Magna Cut?
As most of you know now, before we completely took over the manufacturing, some things went wrong. We re-ran the 3.5s after the run had, we know how that turned out.
Yeah.
So that's not what we're talking about. The thickness of the steel wasn't ideal, but looking at how much the price of the steel had increased since we had last purchased it, we ended up using the 5.120 CV to rerun the 3.5. So,
obviously put a short on having material available.
Yeah. It was a really weird time. Materials availability was really sketchy and prices were climbing rapidly. So we just used what we had on the floor, and then we were going to replace it. So now that we've gone to replace the steel, a lot of 5.1s are headed off to heat treat now in Magna Cut, but when we went to replace that, we were going to order 20 CV, but this new steel Magna Cut had come up. I just missed the first heat of it. It was a little 5,000 pound heat. That turned out to be a good thing, and I think we'll talk about that here in a second.
Yeah. Yeah. So, the number two question is why Magna Cut?
So, Magna Cut is really interesting. Honestly, it's very similar to something I've been grumbling about with 3B. It's just not as stainless as I'd like.
Mm-hmm.
And seeing how some of the European companies had been switching to nitrogen stainless steels, that was very interesting to me. Where, I honestly think Crucible and Laren Thomas kind of nailed what I was going for as close as you could without just adding nitrogen to 3B.
Yeah.
Has really good toughness, an extremely high level of corrosion resistance, and really good functional edge holding. So when we were going to go order 20 CV and 154 CM, the CPM 154 CM, for some of these later projects that we're getting to now, it just didn't make sense. The Magna Cut gives us this really balanced profile that I think fits most applications, especially for outdoor knives. Just having those really good balance properties.
Yeah, it's really high across the board. We're talking about, when we're comparing performance steels, we're not talking about a low line steel to this. These are two steels that are really way up there. 3B being an example.
Yeah. You're getting close to that level of impact toughness with a high level of corrosion resistance. So that's extremely interesting. It outperforms all the previous stainless classes and by a lot as far as impact toughness and that durability. Traditionally, we're looking at stainless steels that have a lot of chrome, vanadium, things that reduce the elasticity of the steel. So you're enhancing, the abrasion resistance, which usually equates to edge holding. Sometimes you're getting carbide tear out, which the new Magna Cut alleviates.
Where we're at here leads directly into the next question. I'm gonna jump in there with that.
Go for it.
Why specific models?
So, this is my handler right here.
I get a little... Yeah, keep him on. He's full of information. We'll keep him on narrowed down the path. But if you got the email regarding the Magna Cut and the changes that were made, you saw that there were specific models that were on there.
Yep.
And a lot of questions you get like, hey, listen, I've got this model. Why can't I get Magna Cut? Or I've got this model. So why did we keep it to specific models? And we're going to answer two questions in this. Like big knives. Why can't my 8, 10, or 12 be in Magna Cut? Why are we right now narrowing it down to specific models?
They may be in the future. Those knives are just really far along in the process to the
8,
point.
10, and 12.
Yeah, specifically.
Prime examples.
Yeah. They've already gone through most of the production process. Those just aren't pouring out of here yet because now that we're doing manufacturing, we're realizing there's a lot of time in each one of those.
Quick sidebar on that for those who have 8, 10s, and 12s on order, just like he said. We dedicate pockets of time to getting these done because they are very time-consuming to finish. And when you're trying to rope everything, we're taking years of lead time down to just months. So all that's got to come to a head somewhere. So scheduling and organization is key in order to make that happen. So everything's based off of time.
like Ellie said, we've effectively had all of the manufacturing, you know, since the grinding got up and running. It's been about 6 months, and we're almost caught up.
That's pretty amazing.
Yeah, I think we're killing it.
Yeah, there's a lot of work, a lot of hours put into that.
And so. Now as we're becoming less and less resource constrained, we're making those investments that need to be made to continue to improve the flow and just keep.
Well, I mean, the proof has just been in
our quality.
The proof's been in shipping labels and knives going out. Yep. But, you know, the example is like, you know, we can grind. GSO 12 takes about, complete is 45 minutes for to finish grind, double grind both sides of the knife. Where in comparison, I think we had the 4.5 bushcraft is, what?
8 minutes.
8 minutes complete. Yep. So, you know, you can dedicate a whole entire month to grinding GSO 12s and then a large majority of other knives don't get complete.
Which we just finished up the, just a quick sidebar again, we just finished up the TAC 4s and 5s, and we're jumping back on 12 grind. So that'll be an update later, so let's get back on track here.
Another big question we get is, we've used 3V for a lot of models, for a lot of things. So how does MagnaCut compare to 3V, as well as it's we're replacing 20CV and CPM 154?
So looking at the stainless steels we used to use, you know, or things we've tried in the past, it has similar corrosion resistance to CPM 20CV without that embrittlement. Mm-hmm. So the impact toughness is way higher. I mean, when we're talking about this new steel, it's not tough for a stainless. It's just tough. Mm-hmm. It's tougher than O1. I think it's edging out A2 tool steel, which is a tried and true standard. D2, some of these tried and true steels, it's tougher than those with a much higher level of corrosion resistance than most of those. So,
and that's the big thing, is the data sheet shows us that information. That's why we can kind of confidently roll into some of the smaller models, because realistically, the people aren't going to go out there and start chopping with their, like, I mean, but as far as it impact toughness and resistance, I mean, comparison to how a 5.1 is going to be used to a GSO 12.
Yeah, and that's something we want to try. And thankfully, we did miss that first heat of MagnaCut, because now we're actually getting some good user feedback, and we have confidence in diving in both feet on this because of seeing the feedback that's coming out from people using it, making knives with it, and getting good user experience out of that. It machines really well on our side of it, and I think it's going to perform really well for most all of our knives. I think for most users, this is going to be the new thing.
But kind of like everything that we do, quality is our number one kind of main goal.
Yep.
And so why we haven't jumped directly into just knocking out big knives directly is because it gives us an opportunity to make them and actually field test them.
Well, we have years of experience with 3D. 3V is really, really tough until you're getting into the shock grades, which I've never liked because they're kind of mushy. 3V is a great combination of circumstances and is a great performance tool. And I, you know, we'll continue to carry that
and this is by no means kind of trying to downplay 3V. I mean, we're talking about
that's a great
two team. Amazing materials.
They're just different.
Yeah, they're just different. They each play into their own environment certainly well as far as the data sheet goes. So. That's kind of the big reason why right now we're not being completely compensating. Yeah, we're 100% going to do 8, 10s, and 12s.
We have a lot of fine-tuning to do with Peter's heat treat to really dial some of these processes in and get the best performance that we want out of our tools. I think that it's not going to take very long. We've already got some good ideas and been passing notes back and forth. So I'm feeling pretty confident.
Yeah, but we're not going to do it. We're not going to just willy-nilly put it out there unless we know we're confident in it. That's going to hold up for our customers and what they're going to potentially put into. One of the last questions that we'll kind of get into is the, obviously 5.1s are been on order for a long time. There's a lot of customers that have 5.1s on order.
Sort of old production.
Yeah, and we have we have a huge batch of 3V heat treated blanks in-house, bevel grinding. We already have sheaths, samples for sheaths out there getting worked on.
Yeah, they're about dialed in now.
And so one of the big questions we get, okay, hey, I made the switch to Magna, or I had a 20CV on order in on 5.1. I'm going to MagnaCut. How much longer am I going to have to wait? What are we looking at lead time beyond that?
So the earliest orders, just side note, anybody who's still watching this, tell the people who didn't watch this long, you're just getting a complimentary upgrade to MagnaCut. You don't need to write in and ask. If you got a 20CV order, that's just already going to happen. It's just better in every realm compared to 20CV, so we're just doing that. We feel better about it. It's more expensive, but you guys are worth it, and We just want to do a better job moving forward here as our own manufacturer.
Cool.
So the lead time, the first batch of MagnaCut is already perimeter machined on its way to heat treat, and we have more sheets of MagnaCut 4 5.1s that should be arriving any day now. So
all of our time-consuming part on the 5.1s.
Yeah, all the setup and everything's done. Yeah. So just get them caught up to these, and I don't think you're going to notice much lapse at all.
I don't think so. I think the only thing that people, like everybody else, all you're going to be involved in is the holidays.
Yeah.
We're dealing with big companies that are going to be closed for, you know, upcoming Thanksgiving.
Yeah.
We have Christmas break. We have New Year's. So we don't have a whole lot of outside vendor operations that we're going to be completely relying on.
No, we're pulling that in more.
Yeah, a lot of those are in. I mean, realistically, we have like heat treat, hardware, and cheese.
Yep.
And other
just
than that,
all consumables.
Yeah, we control it. And a lot of this we've already projected to have brought in and brought down the line so we can prevent this.
Yep.
So those are the only things that we don't have a controlling factor over. That could affect lead times on stuff, but either way, I mean, we're still knuckling in. We're still very confident with the dates that we've
given. And we're very much over that hump of when we were ramping up and growing into this. So everything's smoothed out now, and I feel very confident that shortly after the new year, those will start coming out as well.
Cool, me too.
We will have some 5.1s coming in before Christmas, and we're working real hard to get the MagnaCut blades caught right up to those.
Yeah, so they won't be far behind whatsoever.
No. But
that's it. So that's our MagnaCut video. We're going to, went a little longer than we hoped and anticipated, but we want to take a moment to kind of touch base with everybody, answer a lot of questions across the board, give you some great data and feedback, why MagnaCut and why we're going in that direction, and we'll continue to work hard and put all the product out we can.
Yeah, heck yeah. So, and Shane wanted me to show this off because it matches the shirt.
Since you guys took the time to watch it all the way through
this far,
check this out.
So we have, I don't even know if that's in frame or not, but
come on,
we still have some development that needs to happen, but DLC coatings are entering the chat. We're trying out some different service providers. Some have worked out, some haven't, but there we go, maybe. We are working on those things and making some new developments. So as that starts happening, you'll start seeing those trickling out a few at a time, and then more and more as we get things sorted out. So anyway,
perfect. So thank you for watching. Stay tuned. We'll continue to put out more videos as we can kind of get time. Yeah, he purposely did that to match. So
it's pretty nice.
But again, thank you for everybody's continued support, and we look forward to the new year coming.
Yeah, this is going to be a really exciting 2022.